Good morning, friends. This is the early morning update. I'm trying to these days do it by 6:30 so that you people are able to get it as soon as you wake up, because sometimes, you know, things can get a little delayed. Now, again, yesterday, some people have given me sermons on, you know, how I should stick to my views and, you know, I change a lot. Yes, sir. But the money in my pocketbook grows. Okay. I am not obliged to stick to my view. Okay. Only idiots stick to their views. If there is one quality of a professional, profitable trader, it is that he does everything with the single objective of protecting his capital and growing it and making a view which is consistent with making money. If you can't get this into your brain, please get out of the market, because the market will screw your happiness so badly that you won't know what has hit you. Okay? I will not stick to my opinion under all conditions. Price action dictates to me. Yes, I go in with a plan. In a volatile market, that plan can often change. To be able to change in life with situations, with different people, is the essence of life. Okay, those who don't change are called dead. Jo akad gaya wo murda. Change is the only constant in life. Okay, that is why trading resembles life so closely, because those who don't change end up losing in trading and in life. Okay? Particularly day trading. So, I would think that those people will not be able to hear this. But for the rest, it is not your entry technique. It is not, you know, the five factors you look at. It is always, can you be in step with the market? Okay? Yesterday, if you didn't change and remained short, you lost money. Yesterday, you know, if you were on the upside while the market was going down, you lost money. So, stop being idiots. Change as and when needed. Otherwise, I will be losing nothing. If you think that, you know, you can get spoon-fed, and every day the market should behave like my dog. I should ask the market to sit, and it sits. If I ask it to, you know, wag its tail, it does that. Right. The market is supreme, period. You are wrong. Your analysis can be wrong. The market is always right. Okay. And if you cannot accept that, do not accept that, please get out of the market and stay miles away from it. Because all this ego will collapse. So if you can learn nothing else from here, learn that, excuse me, you have to respect the market. When I am in the market, you know, my attitude is very simple. I am always looking for problems in my analysis. I am always looking that where could I be wrong? What could I be not watching? Okay. Every day when I go to the market, I assume my analysis is wrong. Because only then will I see the clear picture of the market. If I am wearing dark glasses, then I will not be able to see if the market is doing something different. That is the attitude of a successful trader. An idiot is always thinking that he is right. An idiot is always judging which analyst is right, which analyst is wrong. No problem. Idiots lose their money and leave the market every day. So, develop the correct attitudes before you are able to make consistent money. Now, enough of this. Nifty for the day, I had defined the range clearly yesterday. 11,100 to about 11,400. I am still trading the boundaries unless proven otherwise. Okay. If we are opening to the upper end of the range, my first trade will be on the downside. Again, if we are opening about the middle of the range, like 11,250, etc., I want to see what does the market do post the open. Does it do a small dip and then start to move higher? Or does it start coming off with great amounts of momentum? So whichever boundary I get first, I will take the other side. Similarly, Bank Nifty, I have given a range 28,200 to about 29,300. In terms of sectors, I think still pharma and IT may continue to move higher. Meanwhile, some of the FMCG stocks like Asian Paints, Pidilite, etc., they may move higher. Global stocks are likely to move lower. So, basically, keep your capital safe. See which side people are getting trapped and take the other side. That is how the market is behaving. There are times when the market does a 25-point range. The opportunity in those markets is low. In a market which is moving 150 points two times a day, The opportunity there is high, provided you understand this phase of the market and act accordingly. This is not a trending market. This is a highly volatile sideways market. So trying to do what you do in a trending market in this market will only create losses. Okay? So be very careful of what sort of strategies you are deploying. The wrong strategy in the wrong market, even if that strategy per se in a different market is right, will create problems. So first figure out the pitch. If it's overcast, play three fast bowlers. Okay. If it's a flat wicket, you know, the weather is sunny, play spinners. That is how you make money in all conditions. If you are only able to play in one condition, then the same thing which is happening to India and New Zealand will happen to you in the market. I hope my messages are more important than whatever, you know, levels I give. Levels you can find on the chart. But till you develop the right attitude, the right approach, you know, you can keep wasting your time and make zilch. That should be it. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor.